Hi everyone, it's Jean here. I'm talking to you on video this year for our county celebration, and it's a bit different. It's been very different over 2020, but what we've got to really try and remember is what some of 2019 brought for us. Well, first of all, we've got some new leaders, we've got people who've done qualifications. It's all been very busy. I think the big thing for me in 2019 was going to Sheffield to the big gig, and there was lots of us there. Went down by train or coach, saw the vamps, and that was one expedition really for those guides and rangers that we have. And another super event that happened in December were for our younger members, the Rainbows, and we went on the Santa Express at the MC Railway, which was wonderful. Not too cold, and everybody saw Father Christmas and came away with a present, which was lovely. We had the amazing guides from Cross Hills who went to Sparkle and Ice again and coped with extremes of weather once again. They are amazing. They do love the extremes. So yes, I think 2019 has got lots of positives. We also had a big birthday party, which was for second Bilton guides. It was great to go. Super cake that was there and lots of fantastic pictures and memorabilia. So I think that we have to remember what was good, and we were with the guides and the brownies and all the girls and volunteers. And then in March time, lockdown came. But that didn't stop our amazing volunteers. They got Easter activities ready, lots and lots of them had. And so off they went, delivering packs of Easter activities, different challenges for girls to do at home, different newsletters. And then we all realised that actually we could still stay in touch with the girls because we could Zoom. And of course we had our Zoom badge designed by a young lady at Six Ripon Guides, thank you. And then we've seen lots and lots of you Zoom and do activities, scavenger hunts around the house, different mystery trips and sounds that we've tried to adapt from all of our programme. And another highlight that happened virtually was our county camp. Sadly, we had to cancel it, but that doesn't stop the outdoor team. They were away, so we had little videos running all day. We all slept out in our tents, and it means that we could think about what we were missing, but hopefully we'll be there next June at Bramhope with each other, fingers crossed. And then the other thing that I can't forget to mention has to be our Sunflower Challenge. We have sent out 102 orders for sunflowers. They've gone as far afield as Australia, America, Scotland, Cornwall, Devon, Wales, lots down to the south, to Kent and Norfolk, and of course in the county. You've all been amazing. And the photographs that have come in, some of the sunflowers are just huge. They're so tall. And the winners are all getting a little trophy on who was the tallest. Hopefully they'll be out very, very soon. So I think the Sunflower Challenge for me meant that we could still stay connected with those girls. And then of course at the end of September we were allowed to meet face to face again. And I know many of you have tried Zoom and you've enjoyed it. Some tried Zoom and didn't. So we are trying to get back face-to-face indoors to meet some of our girls. We've got to be careful, we've got to stay within the guidelines, but it is lovely to see their faces again. And some of you who are struggling either through venues not being open or just availability of leaders, I know you're doing all you can. We promised to do our best, and I know that's what you'll be doing to stay connected to all the girls. So I hope that you enjoy our virtual county celebration. I am so proud to be the county commissioner of this county, and I would like to say congratulations to all of the volunteers for their long service. I'd like to say congratulations to our Laurel awardee, and a couple of other special congratulations, one to Sophie Hawkes from First Knaresborough Guides, who achieved her Queen's Guide Award, which was lovely to see. Not giving it to her yet, but we will get to see her face to face hopefully soon. So stay safe, take care, and thanks for all you do.
Thank you. I just want to say a massive hello to everybody. We've just had our county celebration day. We'd like to thank everybody who was able to come. It's been very different this year, as the whole year of guiding has been. We hope you've all stayed safe. We want to take this opportunity to say thank you to those who've continued to work throughout this pandemic, and we just hope you all stay safe as well. I'd like to invite you back to Burke Crag. We're here a year on, we've got a roof on, we've got, you know, outside walls, the larch cladding looks brilliant, and we've got the rendering in place, so we're really making good progress. The pandemic has hit us really hard this year. We would have hoped to have made much more progress than we have, but we're getting there. So we're now looking on a really big push for next year. We want to get the downstairs sorted, so definitely watch this space, stay with us, keep supporting us, and we can't wait to welcome you next year to Burke Crag Centre.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls.
Welcome to our 2020 County Celebration. What a year it's been. Unfortunately, I can't be with you due to government restrictions. I'm at home in my garden. That's a first. We've had a lot of firsts this year with units not being able to meet, but I am really pleased and impressed to hear that some units have carried on with their guiding. Well done to everybody. I've heard there are some Zoom meetings, there are some activity packs, and even badges awarded. Some of you have had a go at the Sunflower Challenge. Well, the seeds had mixed reaction as they grew. Some did well, some not so well, but I hope you all had fun. I even heard there was one 3 metres high. Not mine, I'm sure. I hope you have a go at the skipping badge, which should be a great deal of fun. It would be lovely to find that North Yorkshire West is known as the skipping county. All funds will go to Burt Crag, our big build. Talking of the big build, I can't think of anywhere better than to choose Burt Crag this year to meet after this extraordinary year of lockdowns and everything else and issues that have happened. It's an impressive building. Okay, it's not finished, but it will be at some point.
On behalf of the Chief Guide team, I am delighted to be able to send congratulations on your Laurel Award. The award, of course, recognises the outstanding leadership and teamwork skills that you've shown and the various roles that you've held in Girl Guiding. The awards committee's citation describes you as the kind of leader that every unit, county or region relies on. It's really clear how well respected and liked you are by your fellow leaders and girls of all ages. We are so grateful for all of the commitment and time that you have given to helping to develop and support guiding for girls and young women, and the impact that you've had in Northeast England and in the UK. I hope you have the opportunity to celebrate this well-deserved achievement and reflect on your service in guiding. Thank you again for all of your time, commitment, passion and enthusiasm. It's because of members like you that we are able to offer girls amazing experiences. Thank you and congratulations again. Leslie, it's great to be able to send you a message on receiving your 50-year long service award. What a milestone and what an amazing commitment to guiding. Thank you for all you do to keep guiding going, and thank you for your commitment and energy and time. Holding the role of District Commissioner 4 times is a particular achievement, and those Commissioner roles really are vital. They are the essential links to guiding in our units. It's fantastic that you still help out with Mass and Rainbows and Brownies as well, and that was really great to hear. We are so grateful for the time, commitment and dedication that you've given to guiding over the past 50 years. Please know that you and it really are valued. Thank you so much again and well done. Joyce, Chris and Sally, it's great to be able to send you a message of congratulations on receiving your 40-year long service award. That is a real achievement and such a commitment to Girl Guiding. And it was really great to hear about the different ways that you've supported guiding over the years. Sally, that you're still an active leader in Harrogate. Joyce, all your time as training advisor and training all of those leaders on first response. And Chris, as Brownie advisor for all those years, really supporting leaders to take girls on their first adventures. Guiding began with that vision of creating a space for girls to challenge themselves, to take risks, to try new things. And your achievements really represent all of the ways that you're supporting Guiding to continue to do that. Thank you so much for all of your time, your talents, your commitment and your energy. Without leaders like you, we wouldn't be able to offer the amazing opportunities and experiences that we do. So thank you so much again for your time and commitment to Girl Guiding.
I would like to thank you individually for the work and the effort that you've given our girls, for the fun that you've created and received. Thank you for your time and service that you've done for North Yorkshire West. Congratulations to you all for the award you've received, and I hope you can look back with happy memories of your achievements and your successes you've achieved over the years. Thank you for coming, and I look forward to catching up and chatting with you all once the world has returned back to normal. Thank you once again.